In this video, you'll discover how to organize your business files using Google Drive to keep everything in order. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Welcome to Yes to Tech, where we empower non-techie online entrepreneurs like you to maximize your online presence. So in my Google Drive, I have three main folders. Education, which is where I store everything related to online or even in-person courses that I took, such as notes, screenshots, and assignments, as well as PDFs or ebooks that I can use to further my learning and education. Within the education folder, I have folders dedicated to each course, and depending on the amount of files that I have, such as for Femtrepreneur's course, Launch Your Signature Course, I divide them into even more specific folders. Personal, which, as the name denotes, is where I store all of my personal files, such as resumes, investments, coaching, and fun things. And finally, Yes to Tech, which is where I house everything related to my business and what we will be focusing on today, since we are talking about how to organize your files, specifically your business ones, with Google Drive. So when we open this folder up, you can see that right now there are six other folders within it. Sometimes this number varies, since I like to keep the things that I am currently working on at the least amount of clicks away. The folders that are always in this first subsection are blog, which is where I house all of my blog posts and where I brainstorm future blog post ideas. This way, I have the blog post script even when it has not yet been published and have access to it after it has gone live. Since I write a blog post a week, it's important that this folder is always front and center. Images is where I store my logos in different sizes and colors, as well as stock images related to my business that I downloaded in free stock image sites online. Then we have Supercharger Productivity, which is this exact course bundle. Here I keep the course outline, all of the video scripts, the presentations, recorded videos, sales page copy, as well as all the checklists, workbooks, and cheat sheets that come with each module. To-do is where I keep my master to-do list of everything that needs to be accomplished for each long-term project. And Zero to Wix, which is my upcoming signature course and is definitely the biggest folder out of them all. It also has many subsections within it, as you can see from this, so let's dig in one by one. So About is where I keep my copy stocking spreadsheets and files describing the course. Content Upgrades, which is a listing of all the opt-in incentive PDFs that I offer. Email Sequence, where I have access to the script of my welcome email sequence. Free Email Course, which is where I keep the script to my free 5-day email course, as well as the sales copy and promotional captions and images. List building, which is where I add upcoming or current activities that I am working on to grow my email list, such as challenges, giveaways, guest posts, and posting about my offers and events in Facebook groups. Some of these folders are empty or even just house ideas, but they are great motivators for things that I want to create for my business in the future. We also have pricing, which is where I map out my offerings' prices and returns, mostly in Excel, with pre-sales, early bird pricing, and the actual sales price. We have sales page, where I plan and write copy for my sales page. And finally, YouTube, where I plan and write the copy for everything related to video, either on YouTube and Facebook Live, with idea creation, scripts, the videos themselves, and promotional images. Now, the folder that was within the Yes to Tech main business folder that is temporary is the webinars folder. And it appears whenever I am currently working on a webinar, such as the Ultimate Productivity Boost free workshop. In this folder, I house the PowerPoint presentations, promotional images and captions, workbooks, and the exact webinar script for each webinar that I create. So this here is the exact structure that I use in Google Drive to store and organize my business files. We literally just went behind the scenes, folder by folder, and this structure is both effective and successful to keep everything in its exact place in a way that is super organized and easy to find. A great thing that Google Drive also does is to add this quick access section where it puts the latest documents that you reached and used. So now that you know how to organize your business files with Google Drive, it's time to implement it in your own life. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.